Hello, welcome back sa Chess Vlog. So, I just kakagising ko lang, just had my breakfast and medyo papungas-pungas pa ang lola mo. So, the topic for this video is about how much my VUL policy earned from January 2018 and now at time of the video somewhere in September for 2021. So, more or less, or 3 years plus, yun. So, para ano, walang ambiguity, the policy that I'm referring to is kasi ano, different insurance companies have different discarte kung ano how they will do with your quote-unquote investment. So, bakit ako specific when I said VUL? Siguro yung pinaka-shortcut na lang na masasabi ko dyan is VUL is like insurance with investment na policy. Disclaimer, nagbenta din ako ng insurance from 2016 kulang-kulang hanggang 2019 nung manok may license pa ako, and then I stopped. How I wish naging ano successful ako sa insurance kasi that's a good career actually, lalo na pag sinuwerte ka na you have a steady stream of customers. So that's a very very good career to pursue if swertihin ka. Yun na lang masasabi ko dyan. So, okay, nasabi ko na yung VUL, like ano, half or insurance with investment. So, if you need a further explanation about this or interested about it, comments lang. Refer ko kayo sa kakilala ko. Yeah. And then, so when I, ganito yung discarte ko when I was an agent, syempre, in-apply ko din sa sarili ko how my funds were divided. So it was 50% bonds and 50% equities. Excuse me. Bigay lang. So, just to summarize, pag sinabing bonds, it's a type of investment, Google nyo na lang, but the easiest way that I can explain it is low risk, low returns. Tapos equities naman, these are kinda safe, but it's still tagged as aggressive / high risk, high returns, and these usually are blue chip na stock. So, asterisk, this is not a financial advice. I am not specifically like a trader. So, when we say blue chip, it's like the stock chorba for usually popular companies. And parang ano to yung sa PSE 30, parang top 30 companies sa Philippine Stock Exchange like Jollibee, Ayala, what have you. Actually, meron din akong video about that. Sa ano naman? Sa GCash, kasi may investment chorba din sila. So, I'll probably put that in the description. So, just in case interested kayo. But, I will be placing them all in the same playlist, like personal finance. So, if you have questions, feel free to put that in the comments. So, I will answer the questions to the best of my knowledge. Pero kapag technical na siya, I will refer you to the customer service of the said companies so that mas official yung sagot mo. So, daanan lang natin yung ano, yung packet ng chukan. So, this is, you might have a different look Kasi 2018 yung akin, so tingtsura niya. So, it comes with a reference guide. Again, it really depends on the company. Yung mga usually, how do you make a claim? Yan. Mga riders or supplements na dasal mo lang, wag mong maklaim. Yung what does it mean or ayun, yung explanation ng traditional life na insurance saka yung VUL. Oh, meron pala silang endowment. Hindi ko lang nakita to. An endowment plan designed to provide early and guaranteed payouts for future financial needs. O, diba? Na-explore ko. Diba? May nahanap ako. Anyway. So, yan. Basta marami naman papeles yan. So, I recommend if you do sign up for an insurance or if may ganito ka from your said insurance company, if you have questions, kung masipag-sipag yung agent na nakuha mo, you will probably have an annual meeting with him or her because mali mo, may extra pera ka na, gusto mo na ulit magdagdag. Di open ko ulit ng bago. I actually plan to have additional. So, ayun. Medyo pina-hold out. Ang dami kong ano, dami kong segue. But, hypothetical amount. So, I opened an insurance or a VUL policy with a friend around 2018. So, hypothetical amount, 2.5 a month. So, inano ko na, wait, calculator. Sabihin na ano, naalala ko 42 months yung lumipas. So, anuhin natin. 25 times 42. So, makikita nyo, di ba, 105,000. That is a wrong way to compute how much you should, that's the earnings, ha? Because yung 105,000 na bayaran ko in 3 plus years, that is the premium for both the insurance and the so-called investment. It does not necessarily mean kung magkano yung inipon mo or magkano yung nilapag mo per month, yun yung supposed din na nakalagay doon na hindi po siya alakan siya. It's a VUL. So that's always the miscommunication. So always refer to the table. Oh. Kasi nagulat lang ako kasi accurate. First time kong tignan yung table after 3 years. Because yung when I checked my policy, yung sa app, yung parang compute-compute, yung hypothetical amount was nasa 40 plus K. Again, ano yun? Again, yun yung in-earn niya kasi may mahabang explanation naman yan eh. Talk to your insurance agent kung bakit on the first like 5 years, partial lang yung nalalagay sa investments. Sa ibang companies, mga zero eh, in the first 2 or 3 years. So, you always have to look at the table of earnings. Because based on my situation, parang tama naman, on the third year, nakasaad dito, at around 10% rate of return, it was around 45K. So, 45K. So, accurate naman siya. So, I will probably, because you also have the options kasi to, well, with access specific, to stop payment after 10 years. or continue on. I will probably stop so I can pursue a different policy or a different insurance or investment scheme. Para naman pag tumanda ang lola mo, may mahuhugot naman ako, di ba? Anyway, so should you have more questions about this kind of topics, feel free to comment na lang ha. I will answer to the best of my knowledge. If it's something like very technical or very policy oriented, i-refer kita sa customer service, and that's the appropriate channel. So, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.